Hi, I'm Jim Erickson. I'm the editorial director at informationmanagement.com at TDWI's 2012 World Conference in San Diego. I'm with Paul Flack, who is the Vice President of Enterprise Analytics at Stream Integration. Paul is giving some sessions and teaching some sessions on Hadoop at this conference, and he's also just been doing a lot of work generally in this somewhat confusing still to some of the folks, especially on the business side, world of big data. So, you know, one of the things I think a literalist like me, Paul, is stuck, you know, we hear about the three V's or four V's or five V's, but, you know, a literalist like me gets stuck when I think of the word big. We also think in terms of volume and variety and velocity, but also maybe mass and dimensions and vectors. There seem to be different characteristics that don't just fit well with the word big per se. So what are some of those parameters we should be thinking about when we talk about big data? What does it include, I guess?
Yeah, I think you have all the parameters, and I think there are probably more. Mm-hmm. And it goes along the V's. I mean, we have to, the alliteration is nice, but there's complexity and
right.
all types of things that break the V
right.
pattern.
Right.
But the question is really, what do you want to arrive at when you're trying to diagnose a data problem?
Exactly.
Do you want to keep making the basket larger, throwing more characteristics in it? At the end of the day, what do you have? You have a big term, which really becomes somewhat pedestrian in that, where do you go from there?
Yeah, well,
that's
we have big data.
Big data. Now, what do I do?
Yeah, well, we have big data. We don't have heavy data. We don't have speedy data. So what are we, you know, what are the big problems out there for enterprises when they look at the topic of big data?
One of the big problems is really what others are doing with big data.
Okay.
So if you're riding the curve of big data or the opportunity that it presents for you, you want to know where your competitors are. And then the problem that a lot of people have is, how do I use big data? So what are the opportunities for me to use it? What if I don't have big data? A lot of people are stepping back and say, I don't have big data, so I'm not in that market.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if the big data is your problem, because data's out there.
Right.
So the problem is we need to know more about our business. We need to be more competitive. And that's why big data is such a profound concept. Because people are realizing that they have to make use of big data to be competitive.
Yeah, well, we see some sort of examples, you know, in things like, you know, web logs or research data or large amounts of sentiment analysis, things like this. But the benchmarking, you know, a lot of this stuff seems to be kind of black ops within companies, and we're not seeing a lot of repeatable use cases out there yet. So I guess, you know, for someone looking at this, do they bring in a consultant? You know, do they engage their internal teams? It seems to vary. But is there a sort of a route that you're sort of suggesting for this?
Yeah, I would. And again, I think what's interesting about big data is, for once, it doesn't start with the technology. And I think we need to look at the emerging scientific community around big data and use them as an example. They are very problem focused.
Yeah.
And I think that's what we need to be, or even take it a step higher and become value focused.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where I think the beginning point for big data is to say, okay, first we need to know how do we drive value in our company? What are the problems that will drive, that are affecting our drivers? And then step back and say, okay, no holds barred in terms of technology, in terms of data. What are we going to do to address these problems? And I think that's where the new community takes things.
Mm-hmm.
They're very focused on a problem. They're not constrained by technology. They're very resourceful.
Yeah.
And they know how to step back and solve a problem.
Yeah.
I think that's where we need to learn from that community, and that's where businesses are going right now with big data.
Good. Well, a lot of this is very aspirational. And, you know, I heard Peter Aiken from DEMA talking last week that there is kind of a repeated problem with organizations tend to get very excited and get the applications and the infrastructure ahead of the data. So I guess question one is, what would I do with this if I had it? And then maybe even if I don't have it, what is the data we're talking about that describes the infrastructure that we need to process it, whether it's something like in memory or if it's a node on a Hadoop cluster, things like that. You know, to sort of get the information ahead of the investment in the infrastructure.
Right, and the information is coming from more sources.
Right.
It's not, we have to look further than our own boundaries of our own companies where we're producing data. Data's out there. There are aggregators out there where you can get data.
Right, third parties.
There are companies that are providing the analytics already around the data.
Services.
Third parties.
Mm-hmm.
So the services are there from an infrastructure point of view, but the services from an analytics point of view are already there.
Right.
And it gives greater context for the information that you have in-house. So for companies to step back again and say, you know what, if I look at my own data and get too focused on their own data, that may be a problem. You need to look beyond your own data and see what's out there.
Terrific. Well, we hope folks like Paul Flack will help us sort this stuff going out. He's giving sessions at the TDWI World Conference in San Diego here. Enjoyed talking to you, Paul. Thanks. I'm Jim Erickson with Information Management. Have a great day. Yeah.